Real estate developer Donald Trump opened his new casino, the Taj Mahal, in Atlantic City today. It is the world's largest casino. It apparently cost nearly $1 billion, which certainly makes it the most expensive. It is also an example of how Trump does business. Little of the money at stake is his own. Here's ABC's Alan Frank.
Is this the eighth wonder of the world, or is this, as Donald Trump insists?
It's real estate, it's a hotel, it's everything, but it's really showbiz, and somehow it's just worked out well for me.
$14 million worth of chandeliers sparkle at the Taj Mahal. But as always with the Trump enterprise, the star attraction is Trump himself, who cultivates publicity as one of the world's richest men. And as is often the case with a Trump venture, he is providing the dazzle while other people provide the dollars. To build the Taj Mahal, Trump borrowed $725 million, mostly by selling junk bonds paying 14% interest. He also invested $75 million, which he borrowed from a New Jersey bank. For the Taj Mahal to cover its interest payments, gamblers will have to lose more than $1 million a day. If they don't, the risk belongs to the creditors, not to Trump.
Donald Trump cannot lose. Donald Trump is not personally liable on any of this debt.
The Taj Mahal shines as Trump's slickest deal. Trump does hold title to some fancy properties, like the Plaza Hotel in New York and Trump's Castle Casino in Atlantic City. But many are heavily mortgaged, and eventually nearly $3 billion will have to be repaid to banks and bondholders.
The institutions that finance what I have, they happen to be in love with Donald Trump. But they're not in love with me because I'm a nice guy or anything. They're in love with me because everything I've done has been a tremendous winner.
How much of a winner is already a matter of some debate. In a public filing about the Taj Mahal, Trump certified that his net worth is at least $500 million. But his wife, who is suing for half his estate, claims he has $5 billion.
I have really trophy assets, and I guess they're disproportionately valuable because of the fact that they're trophies, but I have zero idea what I'm worth.
Whatever his worth, Trump has succeeded in insulating much of it from creditors, gambling mostly with investors' money and counting on his customers to lose theirs. Alan Frank, ABC News, New York.
Donald Trump is in the news again, perhaps we should say still in the news. In recent years, no one has soared higher than Donald Trump. He has gobbled up everything from an airline to prize fighters and every acquisition accompanied by a bombardment of self-promotion. His conspicuous lifestyle is the lifeblood of the tabloid newspapers. And now there is that matter of not enough cash on hand. So Mr. Trump is in trouble. Here's ABC's Alan Frank.
Donald Trump built his empire by convincing lenders he was a good credit risk. Having borrowed $3 billion, Trump now owes interest of nearly $1 million a day.
The banks like me because I pay the interest on time, and then at the conclusion of the deal, they're gone, and they go home happy.
But now Bankers Trust, Citicorp, Chase Manhattan, Manufacturers Hanover, and other financial institutions are worried. They fear Trump will have trouble paying off his loans because his properties are not bringing in enough cash. In New York City, Trump has unsold apartments, vacant retail space in Trump Tower, and undeveloped land. In Atlantic City, business is off at two Trump casinos. On June 15th, he is due to pay nearly $50 million in interest on junk bonds. And at the Taj Mahal, contractors claim he owes them another $50 million. Inside Trump Tower, negotiations with the banks are underway. They want Trump to raise money by selling Trump Air, the Trump Shuttle, and some of the other money-losing properties he values as trophies, like the Plaza Hotel in New York, Alexander's department stores, and his yacht. So far, Trump's asking prices have been too high to attract buyers, and some of his critics on Wall Street doubt he will be able to come up with the cash he needs.
He's a big shot who suddenly is a little shot, and people aren't going to get paid.
If he cannot pay, Trump's creditors could take over his properties and sue him for what he still owes. Trump insists that will not happen. He claims he and the bankers will be able to restructure his empire, not dismantle it. Alan Frank, ABC News, New York.
It was not a good day for the real estate developer Donald Trump. In fact, it hasn't been a good week. Some of his bills have come due, some of his big bills, and he doesn't have the money to pay them. Here's ABC's Alan Frank.
Donald Trump disappointed his many creditors today. He announced he could not make scheduled payments of more than $30 million on loans which financed the Trump Castle Casino, his least profitable property in Atlantic City. Trump also disclosed that his bankers have not given final approval to a $60 million refinancing loan he has been seeking for months. Trump still has a grace period to pay the castle debts, but if he fails to come up with the money, the casino could be auctioned to pay off the people who lent him more than $350 million to buy it. Trump could choose to protect himself in bankruptcy court.
If he does file in bankruptcy, that automatically stops foreclosure and keeps him in control of the casino and keeps him operating the casino.
Today's announcement came as something of a surprise. It had been widely thought the banks would lend Trump enough money to help him get through the summer season, when profits traditionally peak in Atlantic City. Trump did make one positive step today by paying another $16 million he owed on the Trump Plaza, his most profitable casino. Still, Trump owes more than $3 billion plus interest to banks and bondholders, and it now appears that he is in for the fight of his life to try to rescue his empire from his creditors. Alan Frank, ABC News, New York.
The developer Donald Trump got a little financial breathing room today. A group of banks has now agreed to lend Mr. Trump just enough money, $20 million, to make the interest payments on one of his casinos. That buys Trump some time. Another $45 million in interest comes due next month. The bankers are also reported to have put Mr. Trump on an allowance, $450,000 a month. Here's ABC's Alan Frank.
Most people think getting by on $450,000 a month is a piece of cake, but Donald Trump will have a hard time. The yacht alone costs more than $250,000 a month. Just the interest on the ultimate Florida beach house is more than $100,000. The house in Connecticut is another $35,000 or so a month. Then there is his separation agreement with his wife Ivana, which gives her more than $50,000 in monthly support for herself and their three children. That's close to $450,000 a month. And it does not count the cost of the private jet, the helicopter, taxes and maintenance on the three-story, 50-room New York apartment, or the scores of servants and bodyguards. Clearly, Trump has some big bills, and his bankers, like Jacques Bouet of France, want him to cut back.
A lot of people spend a lot of money, so I think it's not so difficult to curtail it when you need to.
Trump has to. If he does not drastically change his style, his bankers may yet get cold feet about refinancing his empire. Trump tells ABC News he is happy with his refinancing agreement. He said, "Remember, I came from Brooklyn. I can live any lifestyle I want." As Trump sells his properties, his allowance is supposed to drop, all the way down to $300,000 or so a month by 1992. Perhaps Trump is proving that the very rich are different from most of us, even when they just have more debts than we do. Alan Frank, ABC News, New York.